Hello and welcome back to part 2 of the Victory Road Chronicles. I'm ScottJam20 and in the last part, we made our way through Victory Road, battling Wally and other trainers along the way. And in this part, we will be continuing to explore Victory Road and eventually reach the exit. Now, remember back in part 1, where I told you up these stairs you can obtain a technical machine and you can ground type move? And it is Earthquake, TM26. Doesn't get much better than that, and I will be teaching that move to San Draco. So if anyone was wondering where you obtain Earthquake, that's where it is. Alright, it is time to use Waterfall and head up here and then go to the other waterfall on the other side, because I didn't actually explore that side of Victory Road yet, and there are more trainers there, so more experience points for the team. So heading up these stairs, there's one single battle and one double battle on this level of Victory Road. And let's begin. Now this, I forgot his profession, either he's a Kindler or a Hiko, but he has three Pokemon. And he starts out with a Torkoal. Not too difficult. Spooks takes it out now with a Shadow Punch. And next up, is a Camerupt. So yeah, business as usual, send out Rio, use Waterfall. Yeah, the rest is history, one hit KO. Yeah, he's a Kindler, yeah, I was just forgetting. So his final Pokemon is a Rampardos. You already seen me have one of these prehistoric dinosaurs. So Monblaze takes out with a Mach Punch, and the match is over. Yeah, no, I think I've said that way too many times. I've noticed that, and the match is over. Yeah, what else can I say? Oh, pure ownage? Yeah, how about that? Yeah. So here's the double battle, and here's a Gorobish. I think that's the first time we've seen one. We've already seen a Huntail, and actually, while you watch me battling these two trainers for over a minute, there's actually a funny story I have with Huntail. Actually, that's the other evolution of Clampel. When you use the deep sea scale on Clampel, it will evolve into Gorobish, and likewise deep sea 2 will allow a Clampel to evolve into a Huntail. But that's not the story. It goes like this. When I had Pokemon Sapphire, Clampel was actually a member of the team. I know you wouldn't be expecting a Clampel to be that good of a Pokemon, but it was. Proved to be very strong. Taught it Surf, some other water type moves, and it had like Iron Defense. So when it came to the 8th gym, the whole team was at level 50, and before the Pokemon League, I trained up the team to terrifying extremes to well over level 60, I would say the whole team was level 65, and I was wondering, how come Clampel hasn't evolved? And then it occurred to me, and then one of my friends actually said to me, hey, you do realise Clampel can evolve? And I said, how? With the Deep Sea Tooth or Deep Sea Scale. And what I didn't realise is that Captain Stern will give you either one of the two items, and you're inside, you know, the Slateport City Harbour, and I had a real facepalm moment. I really, literally, I could not believe it. I had the Deep Sea Tooth in the bag all that time, and I could have evolved Clampel right there and then from when I received it, because I did have some friends that played Pokemon at the time when I was playing it, and I could have just traded it to get Huntail. Eventually I did, and Huntail is actually a very strong Pokemon. So, I actually think Huntail is sort of underrated as well, just like Manatrix, yeah. Quite a lot of Pokemon are underrated. But yeah, just thought I'd share that short story with you all. Yeah, very comical, but yeah, I was young, so what can you do? Now I know a bit more about Pokemon and evolution methods, not too much, but I get by with relevant knowledge, like with the team members that I have now. Like, I knew when Zandraco was going to evolve into Flygon, and after looking on Bulbapedia and Cerebi, I knew when Freo was going to learn Silverwind, so on and so forth. Back to Flora Sky, and these two trainers have Slackings, and you know how powerful Slaking can be. You already saw that Slaking on the left completely overpowers Zandraco with an Ice Beam, but who would have thought it? A Slaking with an Ice Beam. I know most of the time these Pokemon loaf around, but it was time for the counter-attack. I wasn't going to let that slide. So my Blaze takes it out, or one of the Slakings anyway. And their final Pokemon is a Dusclops. And that Slaking there is loafing around. That gives my Blaze the opportunity to take that one out as well. So that's awesome. Then Bolt's trying to learn Charge, not going to teach you that move. It's only boosting the power of electric type moves the next turn. And I don't get it. Why is the NPC using Protect? You're outnumbered 5-1, mate. And these two trainers are defeated. Critical hit. Did you see that? That's the perfect counter-attack right there. And those two trainers mark the end of Victory Road. And now we are at officially at the Pokemon League. However, there is one more trainer standing in your way, and it is Sky. Right after performing some sort of dance routine in front of that sign, it's time to battle Sky. His team has gotten considerably stronger. He has 6 Pokemon now, as opposed to 4 when we battled him just before we got to Aragi's lab. So he's got 2 new Pokemon, and he'll be seeing those a bit later on. But right now, let's battle Ninetales. He's at level 48, and it's holding the Lumberry. And also, Sky still has those 2 full restores as well, so bear that in mind. You're going to see him use one right about now. There you go. And I couldn't believe what Sky did. Look, check this out. Rio uses Waterfall, brings Ninetales to the brink of fainting. And of course, Rio replenishes some health with the Shell Bell. But look at this. Sky's actually using his head here. He withdrew Ninetales and sends out Leafeon. So he doesn't actually think I'm going to, you know, send out Rio and use Silver Wind. So yeah, that's the reason why I use Bubble Beam. So coming up is a brief fade in, fade out. So that's me sending up Freya. Freya looks like it's close to leveling up, so that's also good. So it's going to get quite a lot of experience battling this Leafeon. And why? I don't understand that. You've got less than, I don't know, 1/6 of HP gone and you're using Synthesis. Come on. Now, this is going to come real handy now, because Freya's stats have increased. I'm getting really lucky with all these stat increasing moves like Silver Wind and this basic stat reduction. Freya's Silver Wind will deal out more damage. Doesn't quite defeat Leafeon. But then Sky's Synthesis. I mean, this seems to be the running gag in this battle right now. And then, of course, replenishes some health with leftovers. So, yeah. Decided to use Gust just to wheel it down some more. And then Sky has a real herp derp moment. I mean, how dopey can you get? Why are you going to use Dig against a bug and flying type? You know, flying in the air. Dig isn't going to strike a flying type. So yeah, Freya takes out Leafeon now with a critical hit, yeah. That's the payback of being such a dopey trainer. Don't use your Dig against a flying type. That's basic. Come on. So Sky's next Pokemon is Milotic. So that's one of his newest Pokemon. And it's at level 50. and it's also holding the leftovers. I mean, come on. You need to tell me. He obviously cheated to get three leftovers, because he's got leftovers on his Apaldon, as you know. You've seen his Apaldon already in episode 41. But you must have hacked that in. How did you get leftovers on three Pokemon? But hey, I'm rambling. So Milotic's on the brink of fainting, but then he uses Toxic. Gotta watch out for that, because he'll just badly poison your Pokemon and lower their HP much quicker every turn. But with Milotic left over, you'll try and recover some HP, but to no avail. Bolt takes it out. Alright. Next up is Apaldon. Of course he's going to send out his strongest Pokemon, and plus it's strong against Bolt, naturally. So I countered Rio. And yeah, as I said, it's also holding leftovers, the third Pokemon. And it summons a Sandstorm. This you surf. And I don't quite remember, does it take it out in one hit? No, it doesn't. Yeah, it's getting close though. Rio's already level 52, same level as Apaldon. After some training, it'll just be one hit KO in this Hippo. And then the Sandstorm rages yet again. Rio is buffeted. This takes it in its stride. So yeah, Apaldon will cover some HP. But Rio finishes it off with a Bubble Beam. Yeah, as expected. Good job, Rio. Alright. So, Rio's going to recover some HP. Yeah, you've seen this. Showbell. Next up is the Ninetales that he withdrew earlier. Now, after all this, I've only defeated three Pokemon. Because the reason why it seems a bit longer is because Sky withdrew Ninetales for Leafeon. So, Rio can finish off Ninetales. He's not going to use another full restore. Don't know why. I think he's only used one. Yeah, if I remember correctly. So Sky's next Pokemon is Lucario. So I switch out into, yeah, you guessed it, Monblaze. All these fade in, fade out. You don't want to see me selecting the Pokemon, so I was taking a bit of time. I don't know why. I just was. And you gotta like how Lucario came out of the Pokeball there. Look, it's hot. Okay. I'm just trying to laugh at something that isn't really funny, but yeah, he'll laugh at this. He'll get a flamethrower right in the face. So Sky's final Pokemon now is Salamence. Yes, his Shogun has evolved. And no, he has not hacked it in, because Shogun does in fact evolve at level 50. The Salamence, Dragon and Flying type, as opposed to Sandraco, aka Flygon, Ground and Dragon type. And in my opinion, Flygon is better. I know Salamence is used very widely in the competitive battling community, but I for one prefer Flygon. And look at Sandraco just owning this Salamence, and finish it off with a final Dragon Breath. And I stun and dusted, and we defeat Sky. And we get the win. And Sandraco levels up to level 53, and it tries to learn Sandstorm. Not interested in that move. So I make Sandraco stop learning it. Like I mentioned in a previous episode, episode 43 to be more precise, I won't actually be challenging the Elite Four and the Champion just yet. I will be including a couple of episodes after this episode, episode 47, just showing you my strategy. So that'll be me going back to move deleter, getting rid of the HM moves on Spooks and Bolt, teaching them moves like Psychic and Thunderbolt. And in another episode, I'll be heading back to Meteor Falls in order to obtain a couple of technical machines, TMs. So next time on Flora Sky in episode 50, we'll be challenging the Elite Four. I'll see you then. Goodbye.